हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी आर बैक विद द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड एज आई प्रॉमिस दैट आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू ईच एंड एवरी चार्ट डिफरेंटली, ईच एंड एवरी डिविजनल चार्ट. आई ऑल्सो प्रॉमिस यू दैट आई एम गोइंग टू एज मच एज डिटेल एज आई कैन विथ वन चार्ट, सो वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड एंड गो डीपर एंड डीपर एंड डीपर एंड लेट्स सी हाउ डीप वी कैन डाइव दिस टाइम. So this is the video of D2 chart, and D2 chart is responsible for your wealth, for your career, for your hardship. How much amount of hardship you'll have in your life? Will you gain wealth very easily in your life, or are you supposed to get too much of hardships, too much of burden, too much of obstacle while getting wealth? This chart is specially made to explain you your financial conditions. Explain you, will you expend more your income or will you save? Okay, this chart may not give you all kinds of remedies and all kinds of problem solving aspects, but yes, we can find out few remedies about wealth, we can find out few obstacles, and we can remove those obstacles which is creating a lot of expenditure. We can also find out few important things from this chart while comparing from the Lagna chart. See, I am always telling you, and I am again telling you, the most important chart of your horoscope is always your Lagna chart or D1 chart. Whatever chart we make ahead, whatever chart we see, we always have to compare it with D1 chart. We can find few remedies of, we can find exactly in what aspect we have to clear, we can find where we can solve things from another chart. But yes, if you want to see the remedies, we again have to go back to the D1 chart, okay, over here, and we have to see charts side by side. So today is the day of D2 chart, and D2 chart is basically for your wealth, how much amount of wealth you will save, which are the good career aspects, what are your pros and cons, and where do you lose much of your wealth, okay, where is your expenditure. Everything related to money, everything related to Dhanesh is explained in the wealth chart, D2 chart, which is also known as Hora chart. Okay, so basically this is a D2 chart, and we will learn from scratch of how to make a D2 chart, okay. And it is a very simple technique. If you understand and see clearly, it is not at all difficult. Okay, so we are starting it. I am back on the board, and we will see how D2 chart is made. Right. So let's see over here. This is the D1 chart. As I said, we will study this chart deeper and deeper and deeper to understand how deep we can go in understanding things. Okay. So there are two main basic rules while understanding D2 chart, that is how you should make D2 chart, okay. In earlier video, the first lecture, I said that there are few categories we have to keep it written over here because we need it while making another type of charts. So this is division of sum and vision, okay. How many planets are present in sum rashis and how many present are vision rashis, okay. I told you in the earlier video that what is sum and what is vision. You need to see the earlier video to understand sum and vision. Okay. So here there is sum and here there is vision. So this Mercury and Mars over here in this chart is present in sum rashis. All the other planets are present in vision rashis. Okay. So whenever you are making any chart like D2 chart, D3 chart, D4 chart, D5 chart, the first thing you need is the numbering of rashis. Over here in D2 chart, there will only be two filled houses because we are dividing the basic life into two parts, and the most important two parts are in the aspect of sun and moon. Okay, so everything is going to cover in the zodiac of Cancer and in the zodiac of Leo, either in moon and either in sun, because the zodiac of Cancer is ruled by the Lord of Moon and the zodiac of Leo is ruled by sun. All other rashis have planetary lords. Okay, and as you can see that there are two Rashis of each lord, but there is only one Rashi of moon and sun. Right? See, Aries, first Rashi is Aries, first zodiac Aries, and 8th zodiac Scorpio has the lord Mars. Similarly, Libra 7 and second Taurus has lord Venus, and third Gemini and 6th Virgo has lord Mercury, and 9th Sagittarius and 12th Pisces has the lord Jupiter, and 10th and 11th Capricorn and Aquarius have lord Saturn. Only there is one zodiac, fourth zodiac, that is Cancer, which has lord Moon, and fifth zodiac Leo, which has lord Sun. Okay, so how we'll make this D2 chart is very easy. Understand the calculations. Okay, this is the simplest calculations of all charts, but the further charts are very detailed and hard to calculate, but this is very easy to calculate to know the wealth of a person. Okay, so first of all, if the planets are present in the sum rashis, okay, I will again explain you, because this is one liner, I will not force everyone to see the full video of the previous video, just to understand sum and mission. All the rashis which are even in number are called sum rashis, all the rashis which are odd in number are called visham rashis. Okay, then we have understood over here and made a list of planets present in even rashis. In this chart, only two planets are present in even rashis, Mercury and Mars. Rest all planets are present in visham rashi, that is odd rashis or odd zodiacs. So whenever we are making D2 chart, we have to see that if the planets are present in some rashis, okay, and those planets have degrees from 0 to 15 degree, then they will be placed under the Cancer zodiac, which is ruled by Moon. And if the degrees of those planets present in some rashis are more than 15, that is 15 to 30 degrees, then those planets will be placed in the Leo ruled by Sun. And this rule is opposite for Vishakha rashis. Okay, for all those planets present in Vishakha rashis, okay, for those, if the degrees are from 0 to 15 degrees, right, then it will be placed in Leo ruled by Sun, and if the degrees are 15 to 30, it is placed in Cancer ruled by Moon. Okay, so now we'll see. First of all, we have to decide the ascendant, right? What will come over here first? See, the same rule applies for the ascendant. If the ascendant is even, ascendant in the demon chart, this is the demon chart, and see who is the ascendant, the lagna. The lagna is Cancer. Cancer is the fourth rashi, right? Four. So four is sum rashi. Now we have to see the ascendant degree. What is the degree of ascendant? 5 degree 14 minutes 11.37 seconds. Okay, so 5 degree, where is 5 degree? 5 degree is between 0 to 15. Yes, so the ascendant sign will be Cancer, or say Moon. So over here we'll write number 4. Okay, now if the ascendant sign is even sign, okay, consider this as over here there is 4, but the degree is more than 15. Okay, if the degree of lagna is 18 degree, 19 degree, 23 degree, 25 degree, okay, then over here the sign will be Leo. Okay, here would be number 5, here there won't be number 4. Okay, in this case, if over here the ascendant degree is 25, okay, 25 comes between 15 to 30, then we will write number 5 over here. But just because over here the ascendant sign is 5, which comes 0 to 15, then we will write Cancer, that is number 4. Okay. Similarly, this rule is applied because the ascendant is even number, okay, 4. That's why this rule is applied. If the ascendant is of odd number, likewise, if over here there is Libra, okay, this number 7 was over here, then we have to see this rule. If there is odd number ascendant over here and the degrees are between 0 to 15 degrees, then we have to follow this Visham rules. Okay, then 0 to 15 will come Leo, and there will be number 5 over here. And if there is odd number 7 over here and the degree is 25, okay. Then this 25 comes from 15 to 30 degree and the ascendant is again 4 over here, okay. So the rule is just interchange, but you have to remember this thing. For all even sign, 0 to 15 is Cancer, 15 to 30 is Leo, and for odd sign, 0 to 15 is Leo and 15 to 30 is Cancer. But in order to place all different planets over here, first we have to place the ascendant. So the same rule applies to the ascendant, okay. So we saw the ascendant, we saw it is even number, and with the even number sign, then it is in the sum sign. So following the sum sign, watching the degrees, we see that it is between 0 to 15, so we wrote 4 over here, right. So after that, we'll continue numbering over here, so we can finish it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, and 3. So this is how we decided how the numberings will come, okay. Over here, we have started with Cancer. So now, similarly we will place planets over here, right. So let's see, first of all in D2 chart there won't be Rahu and Ketu. So we'll just add planets over here. Let's see, what is the first planet? First planet is Saturn over here in the list. Okay, Saturn is present in which zodiac over here? Odd number zodiac, okay. So which rule we have to follow? We have to follow the Visham rule. In Visham rule, what is the degree of Saturn? 12 degree 34 minutes. So 12 degree 34 minutes, which is 0 to 15, okay. It comes between 0 to 15. So we'll add Saturn in the Leo zodiac, okay. So we'll add Saturn over here. Okay. This is Saturn, right. Similarly, next planet is Sun. Where is Sun present? Sun is present in odd zodiac. Visham. Okay. Again, what is the degree of Sun? Degree of Sun is 25. 25 comes from 15 to 30. So, over here following the rule, it will go under Moon zodiac. So, Sun is over here. Next is Jupiter. Jupiter is present in which zodiac? 9 number. Odd number? Yes. So, degree 19 degree. 19 comes between 15 to 30. So it again goes into Moon zodiac. Okay. Next is Venus. Venus, where is Venus sitting? Venus is again sitting in odd zodiac. Following the Visham rule, what is the degree of Venus? 2 degree. Where does 2 degree come? Between 0 to 15? Yes, we will set it under Leo. Okay. So here there is Venus again. Now, what is the next planet? Mercury. Where is Mercury planet? Present. Mercury is there in even zodiac. So we have to follow some rule. What is the rule? What is the degree? 0 to 15. 0 to 15, where is it placed? Moon. So we will place it under Cancer zodiac. Okay. Similarly, next is Mars. Where is Mars sitting? Mars is sitting in number 10. We have to follow the rule of sum. What is the degree of Mars? 10 degree. Where does 10 come? 0 to 15? Yes, we will set it under Moon. So again, Mars comes over here. Okay. What is the next sign? Next planet is Moon. Okay, Moon is present where? Moon is present in first zodiac. First is odd, Visham. What is the degree? 18 degree. 18 comes from 15 to 30, which means it is again going to sit in Cancer zodiac. Okay. So this is how we follow and make a D2 chart. Okay. This is it. There is no Rahu and Ketu over here in D2 chart. But in my perception, like in few astrology and zodiacs, people do keep Rahu and Ketu. But I don't think Rahu and Ketu are a part of your wealth chart. Only it is there to... If the Rahu and Ketu are present in Kendra, only then we have to include Rahu and Ketu over here. Okay. That is what I think. Because in few zodiac they are keeping Rahu and Ketu, in few astrology system they are not keeping, in few astrology system they are keeping. Okay. But in what I have understood, what I have seen experimentally and practically from people to people, and watched the tendency of people, studied them, I understood and saw that among 10 people with Rahu and Ketu in Kendra, the Rahu and Ketu is going to affect the Ketu chart. And those people who are not having Rahu and Ketu in Kendra, Rahu and Ketu are not going to affect the D2 chart. That is my personal conclusion. Okay. Because that is what I understood practically. So in this chart we have Rahu and Ketu in Kendra. Yes, it is present in Kendra. Kendra is this. In between square is called Kendra. So where is Rahu? Rahu is in odd number sign. Okay. Vision. So what is the degree of Rahu? 7 degree 51 minute. But for Rahu we always have to consider the degree 30 minus the degree of Rahu. Okay, always. In every case. So over here we are again considering it after subtracting 30 from it. Okay. So when we subtract 30 from 7 degree 51 minutes, it will come around 21, which is going to come around between 15 to 30 degrees. And where it is present? Vision. Okay, odd number sign. So where it will go? It will go in the moon zodiac, because it is Visham present over here, and we'll consider the degree as 30 minus 7.51, which is between 15 to 30. So we'll just add Rahu over here. Those people who want to keep it can keep it. Those people who doesn't trust me can eliminate it. Okay. Similarly, if we see Ketu, okay. For Ketu, we always see the opposite rule. Okay. For Ketu, we always see the opposite rule. Even while counting aspect of Ketu, Ketu is the only node for which we count from opposite, like clockwise. For all other planets, we calculate anti-clockwise. Okay. So for Ketu, we again have to reverse every rule. Okay. That is what Ketu is. You have to reverse all the rules for the Ketu. Okay. So right over here, let's see. Where is Ketu present? Ketu is present in Visham. Okay, odd number sign. And what is the degree of Ketu? 7 degree 51 minutes. Okay, but we have to reverse this rule for Ketu. Okay, so where is 7 degree 51 minutes coming? Between 0 to 15. So technically it is going to go in Sun. But just because Ketu is always about reversing things, so we will keep it under the moon zodiac. Okay. Okay. So Rahu and Ketu again comes in the 4th zodiac. Those who don't trust me can erase Rahu and Ketu from the board inside their head. I trust myself, that's why I am going to keep it. Okay. So this is how a D2 chart is made. So basically we made D2 chart, all the planets are present over here in just 2 signs and 2 houses. Okay. So now we will study the basic rules of D2 chart. We don't have to study each and every house and everything for understanding people's wealth and okay. So it is useless thing. We will just study few aspects and we will understand what career choice, what everything is going to happen in the financial condition of this person. Okay. So first of all, we have to understand that, see, this moon is a feminine planet. Yes. So the Cancer is a feminine zodiac. Yes. Similarly, Sun is a masculine planet. Yes. So Leo is masculine zodiac. Yes. Okay. So what we see over here, that there are two partitions, masculine and feminine. So we have to see, first and foremost thing, we have to see masculinity and femininity of the planets. If a masculine planet is present in masculine zodiac, that is, if masculine planets are present in Leo, it will give good result. If feminine planets are present in Leo, it will not give good result. If feminine planets are present in Cancer, it will give good result. If masculine planets are present in Cancer, it is not going to give good result. Okay. So you just make small marks over here. Right. Let's see. Over here, Saturn is feminine planet sitting in Leo, which is not going to give good results. So we put a small cross over here. Venus is again feminine planet present in Leo, not going to give good result. So we put cross over here. Okay. Now Sun is a masculine planet present in Cancer. Cancer is the sign of femininity. Okay. So in this, feminine planets are good, masculine are bad. So Sun is not good. Jupiter is again masculine, not good. Moon is feminine, yes, very good. Mercury is feminine, yes, very good. Mars is masculine, so not good. Rahu is technically masculine in nature, okay, so not good. And Ketu is feminine in nature, so good. Now few people will always contradict me by saying, how do you know that Ketu is feminine because it is not written in the scriptures? But understand, there are few things which is not written but personified in the scriptures and biologically present in the body. See, talking about Rahu, why is Rahu masculine? Because all the male people with male body, okay, the male psychology and the male neurological system is different from the female neurological system. Just because a male has a very good power on alpha behavior, just because a man is made for alpha behavior, and Rahu is very well known for his alpha behavior. There are few traits of alpha behavior, there are few traits of beta behavior. So over here we consider Rahu as alpha behavior, and that's why we add it in the, what you say, masculine zone here. Okay. For Ketu, people don't add Ketu in masculine and feminine zodiac thinking that the lower part of the body, the south node of the body, is different. Females have vagina, male have penis. So they think Ketu is mutable and changeable. But while understanding few things, we have to see the capability of things. We don't have to see the nature of things. I repeat, you have to see the capability of things, you don't have to see the nature of things. Just like a male body is very good in Rahu or understanding or capturing the brain, okay, a male is very good in controlling his mind, and female is not very good in controlling mind. I am not saying females are not good, but technically, biologically speaking, a masculine has a good control and good focus in comparison to a feminine body, okay. So similarly, Ketu, why I consider Ketu as a feminine thing? Because female have ovaries, okay, they store energy in ovaries, and men are incapable of storing energy in ovaries. Now few people will contradict that men have testes. Yes, men do have testes, but the power of ovary is to store energy, and that's why Ketu is always going to function good with feminine energy, and Rahu is always going to function good with masculine energy. I repeat again, Rahu is going to function good with masculine energy. Ketu is going to function good with feminine energy. That's why if you see a skeleton, okay, if you see a skeleton, we can identify it as male and female from the pelvis region. Okay, a female has a very big pelvis in comparison to a male because they have to raise a baby inside it. Okay, so Ketu, the south node, female have very big pelvis as compared to male. So biologically speaking, I am considering Ketu in feminine nature and Rahu in masculine nature. You won't find this conclusion like everywhere in the world. You can check all the scriptures. Okay, few conclusions are only to be calculated out after understanding deeply about astrology and Vedic scriptures. We can't understand everything from reading stories and Purans and everything. Okay, we have to understand Vedas as a point of science, as a point of science of body, as a science of body, mind. Okay, so few conclusions are very important. Over here, I am taking this conclusion. If you don't like my conclusion, ignore it and hear me out. Everything else. Okay, so talking about other planets, this masculine and feminine planets. Okay. So over here, see, this Saturn is a feminine planet present in masculine zodiac, which is not giving very good result. This Venus is a feminine planet present in masculine zodiac, not giving very good result. So if this person is going to wear either Saturn or Venus, okay, they are not giving very good result over here in D2 chart. Okay, just in D2 chart, I am not comparing everything. Okay, so let's see ahead, because there are also few cancellations and everything over here. Okay, now see, this Sun over here is masculine in this feminine zodiac, not very good. Jupiter over here, masculine in feminine zodiac, not very good. Okay, Moon over here is feminine in feminine zodiac, and moreover, Moon is the natural rod of Cancer. It is the Lagnesh of D1 chart, and over here present, it is giving very good result. So Mercury over here is a feminine planet present in feminine zodiac, very good result. Mars over here, masculine planet present in feminine zodiac, not very good result. Rahu as masculine over here, not very good result. Ketu is giving good result. So we don't have to conclude what a person should wear over here, what a person should not wear. We are not concluding about gemstones and anything. Okay, what we are going to conclude over here, that which carrier is more suitable for this person and which carrier is not. Okay, where it is easy wealth and where it is hardship. What career choices is liked by this person and what career choices are disliked by this person. Okay, so first of all we'll see Saturn. What is Saturn? Saturn is hard work. Saturn is doing work on wage system. Okay, doing wage work. Okay, Saturn is also working under someone, doing job. Okay, that is all Saturn characteristics. So see, this person is, Saturn is in opposite side. So if this person is doing job, the person might get money, because Saturn is in the second house of D2 chart. Second house is Lakshmi star. So this person might get money while doing job, but this person won't enjoy doing job. Okay, similarly Venus is everything related to luxury. Okay, perfumes, luxury items, shiny things, diamonds, jewelry. Okay, all the luxury items come in Venus. So if this person is doing fashion, fashionable clothes, okay, all these things come in Venus. So if this person is doing any business or any occupation related to Venus or all such things which I just mentioned, that thing might give him or her wealth, but that won't give them satisfaction, because it is present in opposite nature sign. Similarly, let's have a look over here. Sun is having government job. Sun is working with the government. Sun is working with power. Okay, Sun is working with reputed social forms. Okay, so this Sun is also not going very good for this person, because Sun is a masculine planet present in feminine. So this person is not likely to get a government job. Okay, if this Sun is present in fifth zodiac in D2 chart, that person is more likely to get government job. Okay, or if this Leo would be over here and Sun would be present over here, then also this person is likely to have government job. But over here, the Sun is in Cancer zodiac, the masculine energy is in feminine zodiac, so this person is not likely to have government job. Okay, second is Jupiter. Jupiter is everything related to food, banks, FMCG. Okay, all these things are related to Jupiter. Jupiter is also about teaching, education sector. Okay, tourism, all these things are governed by Jupiter. So over here also, see, Jupiter is in feminine zodiac, so this profession is also not going to serve well. Now over here, Moon is present in a feminine zodiac, that is Cancer. So it is going to give very, very, very good result. Okay, especially if the Moon, the Lord of Cancer, is sitting in Cancer, it is always going to give people a lot of savings. Okay, if this moon is present in Leo, okay, then the person is not going to get savings and they will have more expenditure. But if the sun is again present over here with moon, then both the yogas will be cancelled out and the person will have equal amount of money. The amount of money they will get, the same amount of money they are going to expense. Okay. So moon is related to what you say, mind. So all the profession related to mind, that is management, all the profession that do night work, okay, all the night shifts, okay, all those things which are related to bed and sleeping, things like selling bed sheets, okay, pillows, everything related to rest, sleep, moon, night shift, water, okay, all these things are governed by moon. So if this person is in such kind of occupation, such kind of industry working, then this person is more likely to get easy money, okay, and they will be also happy doing that kind of work. Okay, similarly Mercury is again a feminine planet. This feminine planet is present in the feminine zodiac. So this feminine planet is also giving you a very good result. What are the professions related to Mercury? Mercury is doing business. Mercury is investing in different share markets. Okay, Mercury is gemstones. Okay, selling gemstones. Okay, the business of salt, also selling pens. Okay, so all these things comes under Mercury. So if this person does any of these things related to Mercury, then this person is more likely to be happy and earn good amount of wealth while doing the occupation. Similarly, Mars is a masculine planet which is present again in a feminine zodiac, that is Cancer. What are the profession related to Mars? Mars represents hospitals, so doctors. Okay, blood, working in blood bank. Next is doing sports, exercise. All these things are related to Mars, which include physical work. Okay. So this person is not going to do very much good in sports. This person is not going to do very much good in hospital sectors. Okay. So Mars is in feminine zodiac. Okay. We will not talk about Rahu Ketu right now. We will talk about Rahu Ketu at the end of the video. Right. So this was the first rule to understand where a person would be happy doing the work and where the person would be not happy doing the work, and where it is more likely to succeed and where it is less likely to succeed. How to see your career choices. Okay, this is how you see your career choices. Where you should exactly bloody work and where you shouldn't put step in. Right. So now the second rule of D2 chart is, if there are more number of planets present in the Cancer zodiac than the Leo zodiac, then it is a very good placement and it will give you easy money. And if there are more number of planets present in the fifth zodiac, that is Leo, than the Cancer zodiac, then you will be getting hardships while earning money. Okay, because sun, what is sun? Sun is always burning to do his work. Okay, while moon is just roaming around the earth. Okay, so if there are more planets present in Cancer zodiac in the D2 chart, the person is going to get easy wealth. Okay, बहुत मेहनत न करी पड़े जीवन में ओछी मेहनत है વધારે પૈસો મળે જ્યારે કેન્સર ઝોડિયાક માં વધારે પ્લેનેટ હોય. અગર લિયો ઝોડિયાક માં વધારે પ્લેનેટ હોય તો એ માણસ ને બહુ મહેનત કરવી પડે, મજૂરી કરવી પડે ત્યારે એ કમાય. ઓકે, સો ઇફ ધેર આર મોર પ્લેનેટ્સ ધ પર્સન ઇઝ હેવિંગ લેસ હાર્ડશિપ એન્ડ ઈઝી મની ઇન કેન્સર ઝોડિયાક. ઇફ ધેર આર મોર પ્લેનેટ્સ ઇન લિયો ધ પર્સન હેઝ ટુ બર્ન વર્ક ટુ હાર્ડ એન્ડ આફ્ટર વર્કિંગ ટુ હાર્ડ ધેન ધ પર્સન ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ ગેટ money or wealth. Okay, so let's see over here how many planets are there over here. Keeping Rahu and Ketu aside, 1 2 3 4 5 planets are there in Cancer and only 2 planets are there in Leo. So the ratio is 5:2. The person has to work 2 times and he or she will gain 5 times amount of the work that is done. Okay, so this is how you see the ratio. If there are more planets in the Leo, then the person is going to face hardship, મજૂરી મહેનત કરવી પડે વધારે ત્યારે પૈસા આવે, અગર લિયોમાં હોય તો વધારે પ્લેનેટ્સ, અગર વધારે પ્લેનેટ્સ કેન્સરમાં હોય ઈઝી પૈસા આવે, બહુ મહેનત ન પડે જીવનમાં, પૈસો આવતો રહે. નો મેટર ઇટ ઇઝ મેસ્ક્યુલાઇન ઓર ફેમિનાઇન, મેસ્ક્યુલાઇન એન્ડ ફેમિનાઇન ઓનલી ઇફ ધ મોર there are more feminine planets in Cancer zodiac, then there will be more obstacles. Doesn't mean the person is not going to have more wealth. Okay, so masculine and feminine, we just have to see to understand obstacles and trouble and likes and dislikes of the occupation. But if you want to see easy money and hard money, you just have to count the number of planets. Okay, more number of planets over here, easy money. Less number of planets over here, easy money. More number of planets over here, hard money. Less number of planets over here, hard money. And talking about masculine and feminine, if more masculine are present over here in the feminine zodiac, okay, then the person is already getting more money because there are more planets present over here, but the person is just not happy doing no work or the work that the person is doing. Okay, જે ઓક્યુપેશન ચૂઝ કર્યું હોય ને આ માણસને, એને એમાં મજા ન આવતી પણ એમાંથી બહુ ઇઝીલી પૈસા કમાતું હોય. That is what this chart is showing. Okay. If this thing was reversed, if over here there was Leo sign and over here there was 4 number, okay. If there is 5 number over here, 4 is going to go over here as expenditure. Okay. We will see that later on. But did you understand this? More number of planets, easy money in 4. More number of planets over here, hard money. Okay. મહેનત કરવી પડે. લિયોમાં બહુ પ્લેનેટ છે ને તો આમાં ઈઝીલી મળી જાય તમને પૈસા જીવનમાં થોડું થોડું મહેનતમાં. નાવ અનધર થિંગ યુ હેવ ટુ સી એન્ડ બી કેરફુલ ઇઝ યુ ડોન્ટ હેવ ટુ રીડ ફૂલ ચાર્ટ ઓવર હિયર લાઈક ધીસ. ઓકે, યુ ડોન્ટ હેવ ટુ સી એન્ડ રીડ ધ ફૂલ ચાર્ટ ઓવર હિયર લાઈક ધીસ. યુ જસ્ટ હેવ ટુ સી ફ્યુ થિંગ્સ, ધેટ ઇઝ યુ જસ્ટ હેવ ટુ સી ધ ફર્સ્ટ લોર્ડ એન્ડ સેકન્ડ લોર્ડ. ધ ફર્સ્ટ લોર્ડ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ લગ્નેશ, ધ સેકન્ડ લોર્ડ ઇઝ કોલ્ડ ધનેશ. Okay, so over here, if the first lord of this house, right, is present in the first house, it is going to give very, very, very good result. Over here it is present. See, first lord over here, the lord of Cancer is moon. Moon is present over here. Yes, it is giving good result. If the second lord is present in second house, it is going to give good result. The lord of second house is sun. Sun is present over here. No. So sun is not going to give good result. Moon is going to give good result. Okay. If sun was present over here and moon is already present over here, then sun and moon both will give you good result. Right. But over here, moon is giving good result and sun is not giving good result. Okay. So first house lord sitting in himself gives good result. Second house lord sitting in himself gives good result. Also, there is also another point of view. If first and second lord are sitting together in either first house or second house, then both the lords are going to give good result. Okay. Now you will think that it is always going to sit over here in first house. No. See, consider that this sign was number 5. Then over here it would be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then the 4 number is going over here in the 12th house. This is the second house. Okay, this is very important. This is the 12th house. This is the second house. And this is first house. Okay. If this ascendant sign changes from Cancer to Leo, then over here there would be number 5. Here there would be 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the 4 will come over here. So all the bulk of this planet is going to shift over here and the 2 planets are going to come over here. And this is the house of expenditure. This is the house of Saraswati. Saraswati is wisdom. You get wisdom when you lose something in life. Okay. So in this house, more planets is showing that you are having more expenditure. Also, the Lagnesh will be number 5. Number 5 is Leo. Who is the Leo Lord? Sun. What is the nature of Sun? Sun's nature is to burn. Then, the person is going to face hardships. I won't say hardship. They have to work hard. If there is number 4 over here, they don't have to work too much hard and they are getting easy money. Okay. If there is number 5 over here, their expenditures are more. If there is number 4 over here, their savings is more than expenditure. Okay. अगर आया 5 नंबर आवे ने तो चौथो नंबर आया नो आ आया आया 6 થઈ જાય ને 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 આયા તો પછી માણસ કમાતો હોય ને ઉડાડતો હોય કમાતો હોય ને ઉડાડતો હોય ગેટિંગ માય પોઈન્ટ આમાં શું થાય છે આ માણસ કમાય છે સેવ કરે છે કમાય છે સેવ કરે છે ઓકે યુ અર્ન યુ સેવ ધીસ ઇઝ વોટ ધીસ ચાર્ટ શોઝ ઇફ ધેર ઇઝ 5 નંબર ઓવર હિયર 4 ગોઝ ઓવર હિયર સો યુ વિલ અર્ન યુ વિલ એક્સપેન્ડ યુ You will earn, you will go in expenditure. Getting my point? So, coming back, see over here, if the first load and second load are in aspect and together, then they both are going to give good result. So, this third, which was not giving good result because of masculinity, is now giving good result. Because there is presence of the opposite load, the first load over here. And the another rule for D2 chart is, if the first load and second load are together, in either this sign or this sign, both the loads are going to give good result. Okay. But if the placement was different, over here there was 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, then the 4 will come over here. And both the loads are over here, that is sun and moon, then both loads are going to give bad result. Getting my point? Over here, it is going to give good result. If the sun and moon both are over here, then they will give good result. Over here, they will give good result. If sun and moon are over here, both are going to give bad result. Okay. This, we just have to see only if both of these are in one half. Okay. So, again, see, the cross became a tick mark. Similarly, first node with 12th node is going to give bad result. Okay. If sun and moon was over here, it is going to give bad result. Then, next point is, if the lagnesh is 4, the person is going to get soft money. They don't have to work hard, they have to work soft. Magas thi kaam karine paisa mali jaye, the person can get more money by doing working from mind rather than doing physical exertion. Okay, if number 4 is over here, if number 5 is over here, then the person is going to burn like sun and they have to work physically. Physical kaam kare tyare paisa male, vichari paisa no male, magas thi paisa no male, majuri kari pade, majuri nahi to mehnat kari pade. Agar aya 5 number hoy to aya 4 number che etle mehnat nahi kari padti, magas thi paisa aavi jaye chhe. So Lagnesh means the first house. If the first house over here is 4, then the person gets money from their mind and they have to give less hard work and less exhaustion. If number 5 is over here, then the person has to do mehnat, purushar karu pade. Okay. So this was another rule over here. Next rule is, degree is equals to power. Every degree develop power. Now see, whose degree is the highest? Last time we talked about Atma Karak, Avatya Karak and all those things. Okay. So which is the highest degree is sun. Sun is giving good result? Yes. So sun is going to give more money to this person rather than any other planet. Sun also represents father. Sun also represents father-in-law. Sun also represents government. Sun also represents government. Sun also in D2 chart, it also represents pensions. Okay. So this person is going to get very much good amount of money, wealth and property from pension. Okay. Or say government job, or say government. Okay. Or say life insurance, or say property of their father. Okay. Father-in-law. Okay. So they are going to get good income from them. What wealth is going and coming from? That's it. Similarly, talking about the second most higher power over here was Rahu, because we subtract it from 30. But as we are not discussing Rahu Ketu, I am leaving it aside. Then comes Jupiter. Jupiter is 19 degree 30 minutes. Where is Jupiter? Jupiter is over here. Jupiter is giving bad result over here. Okay. I forgot one more rule. There is one more rule. If there are good yogs happening over here, then the yog karaks are going to get better again. See, if Jupiter is with Moon and Jupiter is with Sun, okay. Now Jupiter is the only planet which is masculine over here, and other two planets are giving good result because of rule 1 and rule 2. Okay, so again, there is Gaj Kesari Yog, that is Jupiter and Moon together is giving Gaj Kesari Yog. Jupiter and Sun together is giving Mahapurush Yog. Okay, so this Sun and Moon will clean the energy of Jupiter, and Jupiter again gives good result now because of Gaj Kesari Yog and Mahapurush Yog. Okay, right? Similarly, this Moon and Mercury is giving Nipun Yog. Moon and Mercury is giving Nipun Yog. So again, Moon and Mercury together is going to give good result. Right. But if you see over here, Saturn and Mars is also giving respect. Okay. But this Mars has a bad influence with Moon. Okay. Mars and Moon is also giving Chandra Mangal Yog. But it is giving opposite energy. Because of Jupiter. Mars is now having the energy of Jupiter also. Because Gaj Kesari Yog is a higher Raj Yog than Chandra Mangal Yog. So that Yog is going to be more active and this Yog is going to be less active. Chandra Mangal is lesser Raj Yog, and Mahapurush Yog and Gaj Kesari Yog are more ahead kind of Raj Yog. Okay. So we will consider Mahapurush and Gaj Kesari Yog and we will not consider the Chandra Mangal Yog. Right over here. And Mercury and Mars is giving Shatrughnas Yog. But the Nipun Yog of Mercury and Moon is considered higher than the Shatrughnas Yog of Mercury and Mars. So we will again consider Nipun Yog, Gaj Kesari Yog and Mahapurush Yog, and we will not consider Chandra Mangal Yog and Shatrughnas Yog because it is a lower Yog, and it means that Mars energy is suppressed by all other energy, right? So Mars is not giving good result finally over here, right? Now if you see over here, Saturn and Venus is giving good result, but Saturn is in retrograde, right? Saturn is going reverse. So Saturn is again going reverse. It is giving Viprit Raj Yog. Because in the Lagna chart, Saturn is in reverse. If in the Lagna chart, Saturn is in retrograde and it is sitting in Leo Rashi, then again it is going to give you positive result because Saturn is going reverse from its original trade. Okay, so it is Viprit Raj Yog and it is going to give good result. If Saturn is in retrograde and sitting in 4th zodiac, okay, supposing Saturn was sitting over here, then Saturn would be a feminine planet again. Feminine planet sitting in Cancer should give good result. But just because over here it is in retrograde, Saturn is in retrograde moving backward, so over here it would be giving bad result. Right? Understood the logic? If the planet is in retrograde motion, it is going to give opposite result. So over here Saturn is giving Viprit Raj Yog of Saturn and Sun because Saturn is going reverse. And Venus alone is giving a bad result over here. So now if you see, now we came to a conclusion. And if you see, which are the good planets? Sun, Jupiter, Moon, Mercury are good for wealth, and also Saturn is good for savings. These things are good for generating income. These things are good for savings. Which is not the good one is over here? Venus. Getting my point? So this is how you read D2 chart. This is how you finally concluded which planets are good, which are not good, because we have also see the yogs, okay, which yogs are created over here, right? Now we will see the degree and power. See, what is the degree of Venus? The degree of Venus is 2 degree 6 minutes. Very less degree and also giving less. So the spouse of this person is not going to give very good amount of money to this person in hand. Okay. In hand, the spouse is not going to give an open hand to their this person to go and spend money. Okay, this person is not going to get too much amount of money from spouse, but the person is getting money from pensions. Okay, the person is also getting money from government things. The son, if son is good, life insurance also gives you money. Okay, so if the spouse is having good insurance, if the spouse is planned something for the this person, then this person is going to get good result. After the death of spouse, they will gain more money. In presence of spouse, they are not getting too much money. If this condition was reversed, if Venus was over here, then the spouse is going to give them money to spend and give expense. Okay, that is Venus. Saturn is giving good money. Saturn is giving savings. That means the friends of this person are very good. They are giving and guiding this person wealth. Okay, they can also be working in their friend's company. Okay, they will be generating money from their friends. Okay, that can also be possible because Saturn is good. Saturn also represents friends. Over here, Jupiter is also good. So we'll see over here from teaching line, teaching sector, this person can earn very good. From banking sector, this person can earn very good, right? Sun is good now, so government jobs are good for this person. Moon is good, okay, so moon types of job. Mercury is also good, only Mars is not good. Okay, this person's wealth is going to go in hospitalization and luxury. Okay, two things that are destroying the wealth of this person is hospitalization and luxury. Mars also represents anger and fight, okay, legal cases and all those things. And Venus represents luxury. Okay, Venus also represents some throat related problems. Okay, thyroid issues can also be a major problem for this person. Mars also represents heart. So this means the person can be having problems related to heart. They can be on heart medicines throughout their life because that is what Mars is giving. Mars is showing that they are going to expand their money in medicine or hospitalization, especially related to blood and heart. Mars is blood and heart, so they might be taking heart or BP medicines. Over here, Venus is not good, so they might be taking some throat medicines. Thyroid problem might also be there. Okay, gas problems will also be there, so they might also spend their money in stomach related issues. Okay, so now taking remedy is a very very deep process. I just explain you once because I don't think people are going to go into that much deep. But yes, if you want some remedies, you can personally contact me. But I am just going to explain it so you can understand. See, over here, what is giving trouble to this person? Mars. Okay, Mars is giving trouble to this person. So let's see, where is Mars? Mars is over here. 10 degree 39 minutes 18.35 second, sitting in Shravan Nakshatra first pada. Okay, so we have to note the nakshatra of the planets which are giving bad result. Okay, so we noted, let's note for Mars. For Mars it is Shravan Nakshatra first pada. Okay, now we have to see, Mars is present in number 4 or number 5? Mars is present in number 4. That means it is present in the wrong sign. If the Mars was present over here, then it would be giving good result. So in order to nullify this Mars, we have to check where is the Sun. Okay, where the Sun should be. Okay, so where is the Sun in the Lagna chart? Sun in Lagna chart is in 9th zodiac. 9th zodiac is Sagittarius. So over here, which nakshatra is? Sun is in Purvashada nakshatra. Okay, so Mars is in Shravan nakshatra and Sun is in Purvashada nakshatra. So let's see. Whenever Moon is in Shravan Nakshatra and Sun is in पूर्व शाखा नक्षत्र और से सेजिटेरियट जोडिया. ओके सी इफ यू वांट टू डू रेमेडी फॉर द मार्स फॉर सेलिंग वेल्थ ओके देन व्हेन द मून गोज इन श्रावण नक्षत्र एंड सन इज प्रेजेंट इन सेजिटेरियस धनु राशि. सो व्हेन द सन इज प्रेजेंट इन धनु राशि जस्ट बिकॉज सन इज इन नेचुरल धनु राशि एंड मार्स वॉज सपोज टू बी विथ सन बट इट इज इन फोर्थ राशि दैट इज कैंसर. सो वी हैव टू पुट मार्स ओवर हियर. सो वी हैव टू नलीफाई मार्स फॉर वन ईयर. ऑल दिस रेमेडी विल वर्क ओनली फॉर वन ईयर. ओके सो फॉर वन ईयर इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सेव द वेल्थ सो वी हैव टू सी द बैड प्लैनेट वॉज मार्स. मार्स वॉज सपोज टू बी ओवर हियर दैट्स वाई वी चोज सन एंड सन ओवर हियर नेचुरली इज सिटिंग इन पूर्व शाखा. ओके सो ड्यूरिंग द ईयर ड्यूरिंग ईच ईयर Whenever this sun goes in Purva Shada Nakshatra or say Sagittarius Zodiac and moon is simultaneously present in Shravan Nakshatra, at that time the person has to donate something to the hospital, donate something to the patients, donate some medicines. Okay. That's how the person is going to save wealth because it is in the destiny of this person that the money is going to go in something related to heart disease, in something related to hospitalization. Okay, so what we are doing, we already in the destiny we have to give money to hospitalization and we have to spend money in medicine. Okay, so we are giving out charity to the same place just to save the money throughout the year. Okay, so what we did, we have to find out whenever the sun is in Sagittarius, sun stays in the same zodiac for 1 month. Okay, ek mahina no time hoy surya is zodiac ma. So sun is going to be in same zodiac every year. Like in makar sankranti sun enters makar rashi, that is number 10. Okay, sun enters makar sankranti on the 10th zodiac on 14 January. So the sun is going to be present in the Sagittarius zodiac from 14th December to 14th January. So in between 14th December and 14th January, whenever the moon is coming in Shravan Nakshatra, which pada? First pada. Whenever the moon is coming in Shravan Nakshatra, first pada, this person has to donate medicines and donate some food to patients and spend time in hospital. They have to go in hospital, give free food to people in hospital, and they have to give free medicine to people, Ayurvedic herbs and anything like that. So for 1 year, they are going to save the expense of more medicines and they will going to nullify this bad yoke. Okay. Getting my point. जरा कबरू छे आने आवस्तु त्रण वार सांभळजो आवडी जशे. पाछू आया हूँ आई अगेन गिविंग एग्जाम्पल फॉर वीनस ओवर हियर. ओके सो गिविंग एग्जाम्पल फॉर वीनस ओवर हियर रिमूविंग द मास सो वेर इज वीनस प्रेजेंट. Venus is present is over here in fifth zodiac. Where it should be present? It should be present over here. So first we will see where is Venus. Venus is present in Mool Nakshatra. Okay, so we will write which pada Mool Nakshatra, first pada. We will write over here Venus. Mool Nakshatra, first pada. Okay. Now, in this case, it is reverse. We don't have to see the sun. We have to see the moon because it is going to be, it should be over here and it is sitting over here. So, we will see the moon. We will not see the sun. So, where is the moon? Moon is in Aries. Okay. We will see over here. Where is moon? Moon is in Aries in Bharini Nakshatra, second pada. Okay. Moon is in Venus. So, whenever moon goes in Bharini, okay, and Venus goes in Mool Nakshatra, at this period of time, this person has to donate something related to Venus. Venus is what? Venus is luxury items, Venus is shiny gemstones, Venus is also sweet, sugary things, okay, cosmetics items, soap, shampoos, everything. Okay. So whenever Venus goes into Mool Nakshatra throughout the year, every time Venus is in Mool Nakshatra and the moon is rotating in Bharini Nakshatra, at this time if the person donates something related to Venus, they are going to save their expenditure. They are going to increase their savings. Right? It will nullify this bad yoga. Okay? Understood the calculation? અહીંયા જોવાનું કે ક્યાં બેઠું છે, અહીંયા જોવાનું કે આ ખરાબ છે એનો મતલબ કે આને અહીંયા હોવું જોઈએ, આને અહીંયા હોવું જોઈએ એનો મતલબ કે આ D1 ચાર્ટ માં ક્યાં છે. ઓકે, વી ઓલવેઝ હેવ ટુ સી વેર ઇટ ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ ઇન D1 ચાર્ટ એન્ડ સી ઇન વિચ ઝોડિયાક ઇટ ઇઝ પ્રેઝન્ટ. સો ટુ ડુ રેમેડી ઓફ ધીસ ચાર્ટ વી હેવ ટુ સી ધ D1 ચાર્ટ. વિધાઉટ વોચિંગ ધ D1 ચાર્ટ વી કેનોટ ડુ ધ રેમેડી ઓફ ધીસ પ્લેનેટ્સ. ઓકે, this chart is only for placement purposes. After understanding the placements and nature, the remedy is to be calculated from this chart and the nakshatra itself. Getting my point? So this was a donation remedy. You can also do mantra remedy. Okay, similarly like Mars, if the Mars is we talked about Mars, so whenever the Mars term was there, when the sun was in, where was the sun? When the sun was in Purvashadha and Mars was and the moon was in Shravan Nakshatra, at that time we did the remedy. Okay, for this one Venus, we have to see Venus is supposed to go in this one moon, so we have to see moon. Moon is Bharani Nakshatra. Where is Venus present? Venus is present in Mool Nakshatra. Okay, getting my point? So in this, they can also give like mantras related to Shukra. Okay, if you do Shukra mantra in the morning, you will save money in this period. Similarly, you have to do Mangal mantra on that time, you will save your expenses. For mantra, I am going to create another video because it is very detailed and I am not going to explain it over here. I can't explain because I have to explain the basic things and all these things. So let's forget mantras. We are only discussing on easy remedies. Okay. So understood the remedy thing? If you don't understood, rewind it and watch it 3 times. You'll understand. I am quite sure everyone is very intellect who is watching my video. That's why you are this far in the video. If you are not intellect, you'll be leaving my video in the first 5 minutes. So if you reached over here, if you watch 3 times, I am very quite sure, I have confidence in you that you will understand how did I help you. Okay. Similarly, Rahu and Ketu. Now this is my thing, my explanation. This Rahu is materialism and Ketu is spiritualism. Okay. See, over here the Ketu is giving good result over here and Rahu is giving bad result over here. Okay. Rahu is also properties and land. Right. Ketu is travel. So if the Ketu is good over here, the person is going to earn well from traveling. If Ketu is not good, they will earn more in the native land where they are born. Okay. Similarly, Rahu is reverse. If the Rahu is good, you will earn more in the native land. And if the Rahu is bad, you will earn more in the foreign lands. Okay. So this is the conclusion of Rahu and Ketu from my side. Okay. So this was all. This was about the D2 chart over here. It was fun explaining the D2 chart. I hope you understand how to understand the D2 chart very well, very clearly. We understood how to compare this chart. I'm quite sure that I don't have to make it right over here and explain it again that if this thing was over here, what implication would be there. Okay, because if these trends were over here, the house of expenditure would increase. Okay, let me explain you, otherwise I would not feel satisfied and there is nothing more happiness than being satisfied. The video might get a bit longer, but yes, I will be able to satisfy myself, satisfy my students एंड माई वन सोल, थोड़ी मेहनत पर से चाल से शनि पेड़ मेहनत करी पड़ से। ओके See over here. If the ascendant sign would come Leo over here, 5, then this will be 6, this will be 7, this will be 8, this will be 9, this will be 10, this will be 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4. All the planets will go over here. Sun, Jupiter, Moon, Mercury, and Mars. Over here it will come Venus and Saturn, right? So if this ascendant sign in the beginning of the chart would come 5, okay, ascendant ahi 5 degree change, but if 25 degree ho to out thai jaye, barobar. Now what happens, see this Dhanesh is empty, the house of expenditure is filled with the house of income, so this person is having more expenditure than income. I am taking a बेसिक एग्जाम्पल जस्ट टू मेकिंग यू अंडरस्टैंड कि अगर इफ द कंडीशन वॉज रिवर्स वॉट वुड हैपन. ओके सो इन दिस ओवर हियर सी इवन दो सन एंड मून आर टूगेदर द लॉर्ड ऑफ फोर्थ हाउस लॉर्ड ऑफ फोर्थ राशि एंड फिफ्थ राशि आर टूगेदर बट दिस रूल वॉट वर्क द लॉर्ड ऑफ वन एंड टू इफ द लॉर्ड ऑफ वन एंड टू इज टूगेदर इन इधर वन एंड टू देन दे आर गोइंग टू गिव गुड रिजल्ट इफ द लॉर्ड ऑफ वन एंड टू वन एंड ट्वेल्व आर टूगेदर In 12th house, both are going to give bad result over here. Okay. Barma garma to kharab ho jabe na expenditure ko. So this both are going to give bad result. Now just because this both are giving bad result, see this Mercury is giving good result. Okay. And this Moon is giving dual result, good and bad, because it is a house lord of Cancer. Moon is the lord of Cancer sitting in Cancer. And the Lord present in the house is more prominent than the conjunction. So this Moon alone is going to give good result. Okay. Now if the Moon is good result, so the Moon and Jupiter both are going to give good result because of Gaj Kesari Yoga. Because Mahapurush Yoga is not as big yoga as Gaj Kesari Yoga. So we'll consider Gaj Kesari Yoga and we'll not consider Mahapurush Yoga. Okay. Similarly, this Mars is not giving good result. Because this Shatrunash Yoga is not considered, this Nipun Yoga is considered. So Mercury will join hands with Moon and not Mars. Over here, Saturn, over here Venus is giving bad result because it is feminine and present over here. And Saturn, just because Saturn is present in retrograde, in reverse motion, that's why it is giving good result because of Viprit Rajyoga. Okay. Understood? So then the things would be quite reversed. See over here now Sun is not giving good result. Sun is giving very bad result. Mars is giving bad result. Only Jupiter, Moon and Mercury is giving good result and Saturn is giving good result. Plus this ascendant sign has become Leo. That means the person has to work hard. They won't get easy money. And moreover, more planets are present in 12th house. So this person is going to have good amount of expenditure in the life. Although more planets are present in Cancer zodiac, so the person is also going to earn easy. But this also means that the person is also going to be expending more. Okay, paisa aave chhe vadhare and jaye chhe vadhare. There is very less saving, or say no saving. Okay, so more money is coming and more money is going. Jeevan chale chhe. But if there will be more planets over here, okay, consider over here there will be Moon, Mars and Jupiter. So now more planets are in fifth zodiac, no matter they are masculine or feminine. This is good, this is good, this is bad. Okay. No matter they are masculine or feminine, more planets are present in fifth zodiac and there is no planet over here and two planets are over here. Okay. So this person is earning good and also expenditure, okay, but they are not saving good and they have to work very hard. Okay. Je mojuri karta hoy ni kundli aavi hoy વધારે ગ્રહ પાંચમા નંબરમાં હોય, પાંચમો નંબર અહીંયા વચ્ચો વચ હોય, અને ચાર નંબરમાં ઓછા ગ્રહ હોય ને એ એને બારમાં ભરેલા હોય. ઓકે, અને જે મજૂરી ન કરતા બેઠે બેઠો પૈસો લેતા હોય ને એમાં વધારે ગ્રહ ચોથા નંબરમાં હોય, ચોથો નંબર અહીંયા હોય, પાંચમો નંબર અહીંયા હોય. ગેટિંગ માય પોઈન્ટ? સો ધીસ ઇઝ હાઉ યુ આઈડેન્ટિફાય વોટ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ લાઇફ સ્ટાઇલ યુ વિલ બી હેવિંગ. ઓકે, આઈ ગોટ માય મેન્ટલ સેટિસ્ફેક્શન બાય અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડિંગ યુ ધ ઓપોઝિટ થિંગ. મને શાંતિ મળી ગઈ અને તમને સમજાવી દીધું કે અગર આવું હોય તો કેવું હોય. ઓકે, સો દિસ વોઝ ધ ડી ટુ ચાર્ટ. નેક્સ્ટ ટાઈમ ટુમોરો વી આર અગેન ગોઈંગ ટુ કમ બેક વિથ ધ ડી થ્રી ચાર્ટ એન્ડ ધ રેમેડીઝ ઓફ ડી થ્રી ચાર્ટ. વોટ ડઝ ડી થ્રી ચાર્ટ એક્સપ્લેન? દિસ વોઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ ડી ટુ ચાર્ટ. હોપ પીપલ લાઇક માય વિડીયોઝ. ઓકે, અન્ડરસ્ટેન્ડ એસ્ટ્રોલોજી વેલ એન્ડ નો યોર ઓન સેલ્ફ. ગેટ ઇન ટુ સેલ્ફ રિયલાઇઝેશન, નો યોર સેલ્ફ મોર. ઓકે, થેન્ક યુ ફોર વોચિંગ.